Welcome to The Piano Boat. I'm Massa.
And I'm Rihanna. We are both classical musicians and last year decided to take the plunge and commission a widebeam canal boat for concerts and musical cruises, complete with comfortable living quarters.
Join us as the boat build reaches completion and we begin our journey along the UK's inland waterways.
Hello again from the piano boat. As you might notice, Mass is looking a bit tired today because he's just done an online concert. So if he falls asleep, just don't mind him. As you can probably tell from the name, the piano boat, obviously the piano is quite a big talking point for us. It's the unusual thing about this boat. So we mentioned last week that we were going to talk to you about how we actually got it in, because there was a big drama around that. And when the boat was being built, we were looking at different options and which pianos would kind of work. And, you know, were we going to bring in one of Massa's pianos? And there was a lot of debate around it. And at that point, when we were looking at dimensions and weight and ballasting and all of these kind of considerations, we realized at that point that it wasn't going to fit through the doors. And this was a few days before the steelwork was due to be completed. So it might have even been a weekend or something. We phoned Michelle from TriStar up in a bit of a panic saying, oh my goodness, this is supposed to be a piano boat and how are we going to get the piano inside? So she said, it's okay, don't worry. I've spoken to the steelworkers and they are going to make the skylight larger. So that is essentially how it came to be. This giant piano came in through the roof, and we're going to show you how that happened today. It was quite an extreme moment in time, I think.
Yes, I seem to remember it was, I assumed it would be okay, and it felt quite okay. I was more worried, I remember, about what we will see next week, when the piano was already on board and then the whole boat was going to be put back on the water, because obviously where we saw last week, where the boat was on hard standing, obviously the piano mover said it's better to do it when the boat isn't on the water to minimize any risk. So it was put in when it was on the hard standing, but then of course they lift the whole thing up and it was surprisingly shaky. So that I found, I remember watching the whole thing and I was thinking, ooh, that looks slightly worrying. Of course it was all fine. When I saw the piano being craned up, I have heard the piano movers are quite incredible in what they're capable of doing. They can put it into high-rise buildings, mansions or apartments or whatever.
They were completely unfazed by it, weren't they? Yeah, just like another day in the office.
Exactly. So I assume they know what they're doing and they looked quite safe and quite okay. So it wasn't genuinely worrying, but it was quite a spectacle, nevertheless.
Definitely. Mm-hmm. And I mean, we do know someone who had their grand piano craned in through the window of their sort of second floor flat or something. So this is in the middle of London as well. So it's definitely not impossible, but this was possibly the first time they'd had to put one on a boat. And so they did actually go to the yard, I think, or did they just have photos? They wanted to see it beforehand anyway.
I think it was mainly because it's quite a large thing, the crane. I mean, the crane for the piano was nothing as large as the crane for the boat, but it was still fairly substantial, so they obviously had to work out whether there are room to maneuver and everything, but I think it was all right. And the whole thing about choosing the piano is quite an interesting thing, so we will be talking about that in the weeks to come, probably. But in the end, we opted for a proper brand new grand piano from Steinway's, so that there's quite a journey with that involved as well. Pianos are funny things. Of course, normally, if we practice at home, the pianos in any concert venues are all different. But here, it's quite nice that you've got your own piano to practice. Of course, I mean, at this stage, I'm not practicing too much. I'm not using it too much because you don't want it to wear down in the same way that you might need a home piano to do. So, I mean, these are all piano-related things. But anyway,
Where were we? I mean, as it got closer to the day when the boat was going to be delivered and the piano was going to go on, Michelle and Jeremy at Tristar and the rest of the team, of course, actually mocked up a grand piano just to make sure that it would fit through the skylight. And that was quite a sight. It was bright blue, and they actually had some keys from a real piano, which they stuck on it just for fun, I guess.
It was really quite tricky.
That was amazing. Yeah. We wanted to keep it, take it home as a souvenir.
In the end, it got a bit larger, though. It wasn't exactly the same. I mean, the width was the same. But when I saw another boat of theirs that the TriStar boats were building, and I just saw the photo, and I thought the front door looks big enough. And I just suddenly thought, hang on, I'm looking at this, someone trying to come out of the inside. And I thought, hang on, it looks rather low. And that's when it suddenly struck me, hang on, have we actually thought about how we're going to put the piano in? And whereas with we actually had thoughts about putting a really decent digital piano, which would have been fine, but certainly with this, it was quite a different thing. But yes, the blue piano was very, very funny.
Yeah, that was probably a highlight of the whole journey to get here. And then another of the big things that Massa did all the research, but another thing that we had to overcome was, I mean, everybody said that putting an acoustic piano on a boat is crazy because pianos and water just don't mix. They don't really like each other. So we had to work out how we were going to create an environment that wouldn't make the piano constantly out of tune, because there are so many things to consider. And you spent a lot of time looking into how best to do that. And we've got, in the end, we ended up with air conditioning, heating, but not underfloor heating. We've got a humidifier. We have a dehumidifier. We've got a rug, which you can maybe see underneath the piano, which the idea is that it's because the ground is, the floor is obviously colder because it's right on top of the water. It's supposed to stop that coldness going up into the piano.
Well, it's in fact just a sort of a carpet designed for underfloor heating.
Okay.
It's the opposite. I just thought I'll get it because anything to minimize the sudden changes of temperature would be good. And of course, it has been, I don't remember doing that much research, to be honest, but I mean, basically.
It was definitely on your mind for a long time.
Well, it was on my mind. It's still on my mind very much. I'm staring at all the stats constantly. Yeah. I wake up at 4 a.m. thinking, has it gone a bit dry? Has it gone a bit cold? So it's quite sleepless, really, just basically. And then there's on the apps, you can see the trends, and I'm just really, I mean, it's settled very nicely. I think I've got it all sorted out. Over the summer, it was really, really hot, and the aircon we knew we needed on the boat, because some of the higher boat holidays we've done, we found that it can get quite warm. It's, at the end of the day, essentially a tin can, a box.
Like a greenhouse.
So it can get very warm, I remember. So we did get the aircon in early. Of course, what we couldn't quite get was means to be able to control the aircon when we're not on the boat. But we found this fantastic device.
Ridiculous.
It's hilarious.
It's absolutely ridiculous.
It works on Wi-Fi. So now we actually did this when we went to Latvia over the summer. It was for work purposes. We went to Latvia. And I noticed the cabin temperature was getting a bit warm, so I actually used the app, and it's fantastic. You'll see.
We'll show you how
in
it works,
action.
But
it's brilliant. This thing, it just basically switches it on for you.
It's called a switch bot, and it's like, yeah. Well, you explain.
Yeah, but it's basically just a little thing that manually pushes the button for you, which you can control remotely. And so we've got the, Hive system. I didn't know, I mean, how is this product placement? We are not sponsored by any of the companies, but Hive has been working very well as well. Again, it's easy to see what the temperature is, and also the SwitchBot are the ones that actually have this hygrometer and the, what is it, temperature gauge?
Thermometer
in one, and I have used one of those kits that you can get to make sure that it's calibrated correctly, and we've got it bang on 55% constantly. And it feels cold. I don't know whether you find this, but 20 degrees feels a bit cold. And I remember in the summer, to bring it down to 20 degrees, it felt quite cold in the cabin. And during the winter, we make sure that it's at just over 20 degrees, which is the recommended temperature, 55%
humidity.
And it feels somewhat cold, but that's what it is, it seems to me. If I'm practicing, then it's okay. So if I'm just
you've got to be doing some exercise.
If you're just watching television or something and not really moving much, it feels a bit cold, but there we are. So that's basically what it is. The temperature and the humidity, those are the two things. And talking of water, we're not in water. So it doesn't really affect at all as long as the temperature and the humidity is stable. Yes, I think this is actually under the waterline. I still find it quite amusing when I look out the window and find the waters like there. It's quite an amusing sight to imagine that we're actually below the waterline. We're sat below the waterline, but it's not underwater or anything. We don't have water. We're not splashing around in water. So the piano's absolutely fine. And if anything, during the winter month, it can get too dry. And I'm finding it is getting too dry. The humidifier has been working quite hard.
So there was all of that research going on and all of these considerations before we even got to the stage of having the piano. So then along came the day. It's arrived in a van, just a very ordinary looking van. And they fastened it up with straps, just like the boat when it was being craned off the lorry. And hoisted it up into the air and just basically dropped it in through the roof, gently. And then here it is. Though we knew that obviously the piano is in good hands because these are professionals doing it, it was quite a relief still to kind of see that it had made it safely into the boat with no mishaps. And you know, they wrap it up really tightly in lots of padding. And actually one of the concerns was that it might not even fit through the skylight because it was such a small margin. I think it was only a couple of inches that they had to spare. So we were mildly concerned that it actually might get stuck halfway, but fortunately it didn't. But I think we sort of breathed a sigh of relief at that point, even though it really would have been fine. And, you know, they're doing this every day. I think they had to go off and do another one after that, so they left quite promptly. But
I suppose when I sent the dimensions in to Steinways, who was in touch with the movers, and we gave them the precise measurement and they came back to say it's okay. And that was the moment of relief for me, because as you said, the padding was a bit of a worry because obviously they all looked like there should be enough. The blue piano was absolutely fine. It would go in and out very easily. But with the padding, is it going to work? There was that sort of slight sense of fear. I mean, there's so many relief moments that's, you know, I mean, like the other one, completely separate. But when we actually cruise through, which is much more later on in October, when we cruise through central London, we were really worried, are we going to fit through the two tunnels, the Maidervale Tunnel and the Islington Tunnel? And we have. And that was a huge relief.
Mm.
I mean, this is completely something else.
Quite
but
scary.
There are many moments of these, you know, this concern, and it worked, that we tend to forget.
Yeah.
What sort of being am I? I tend to forget the things that's worked out and just still looking at, oh, that hasn't worked. Oh, that hasn't worked.
Yeah.
But that's the nature of who I am.
So that
has worked.
But I think, you know, actually seeing the piano in the boat was really quite exciting. And then that first evening you were just playing away and it was just amazing. And, you know, even with all these delays and we had bookings for May and June and we had to cancel them or at least postpone them. And this was in July when the boat and the piano finally arrived. So the whole thing had been delayed and we still don't know, you know, if we're going to be able to run any cruises in the near future. Just it all depends on the pandemic. But, you know, amidst all of this, it was really exciting to kind of see the piano and think, oh, my goodness, what have we done?
It was basically, well, for me, it was one after another of panic. I mean, in the summer, we tend to forget now as well how cold it is now, but it was really warm.
Yeah,
and on like the hard standing, we didn't have the aircon working at that time. It wasn't hooked up or anything. It was just literally sitting there. So for a whole week, I would come onto the boat and open up the windows and then close them before before the evening, to keep it
as cool as
to keep it cool as possible because it was so hot. So I'd open the windows, but it was just every day and that, and it just I felt so bad because it was too warm. It was definitely too warm. It hadn't been June, of course, but it was definitely too warm those days. And then, of course, come the winter, there was a point where the heating wasn't quite working as it should, and it got rather cold.
Really cold.
And of course, now you can hear the creak of the radiator. We've got an electric
heater.
Radiator, not an air blowing heater. I always associate heater with air blowing heaters.
Really?
This is radiator. It's an oil.
I thought a radiator is fixed to the wall.
It's definitely a De'Longhi radiator, which...
It's got wheels anyway, you can wheel it around.
It's really been working very well. It helps for the stable temperature because that way we don't have to warm up the whole boat all the time, just as long as the saloon is kept to that stable temperature. We've got these air circulators gently making sure...
Fans going around.
Making sure that the air is being circulated.
Which will actually go onto the stove when we get it. Kind of lit at some point, but
The stove is another thing entirely. At this point, you can't. I mean, you can see the wood stove right there. Wood stove. Don't worry if anyone's watching and think wood stove next to the piano.
No. I was about to say we need to move the piano out of the way, put up a screen with some heat proof whatever, and just kind of monitor it, but. But anyway, the point is that we kind of bought the little fan to go on the stove as a circulator, but we haven't.
Well, that fan is not a circulator. This is just a fan. It's pretty. It's nice. I'm sure you've seen it before on wood stoves. You put it and it generates the energy and in turn the fan. The circulator is the one with this funny pattern which really pushes the air straight through, as opposed to a normal, summer blowing fan where it just pushes the air a bit. But the circulator is quite effective.
Mm.
So we do have these things in place to really make sure that the saloon is kept to a constant temperature.
I mean, I guess we talk quite a lot about keeping the environmental controls really steady, but we've actually had quite a few questions about it from other people who want to put pianos on their boats. So if you are wondering what we've done, there you go. Now you know. It's been a big project. But I guess that having an acoustic piano, you can see it's actually open at the moment. This is not normal. Normally it's like covered up and, closed and asleep.
It's a thick quilt.
Yeah, quilt.
Quilt cover as well. Talking of putting acoustic piano, we might make it too confusing, but it's actually not. As long as the temperature and the humidity is stable, that's all it is. Possibly aircon might be the only issue in the summer. To keep the cabin temperature cool. But certainly in the winter, I don't think there's a huge issue, really. And dehumidifiers, I mean, this is not a very expensive model or anything. It does the job. It keeps it can be a bit noisy. So obviously we'd have to turn it off during concert cruises and all that. But it's fairly simple things. Humidifier, dehumidifier, you can get them anywhere, really. Fairly straightforward. So aircon is possibly the only issue. If you're thinking of bringing on acoustic.
I guess normally you wouldn't have air conditioning on a canal boat, and it's certainly not something we would have considered otherwise.
We don't have air conditioning at home.
No. but it's really just actually that kind of tied into having the big battery bank, which is also tied into the hybrid. So maybe we'll do another video on that at another point, but it really, otherwise it wouldn't have been possible. So there was quite a lot of power hungry, energy hungry things, which is why we needed this complicated system that I can't get my head around. But yeah, that's basically it.
Yes, I mean, it's basically they're very separate things. Hybrids are amazing. It's really near silent cruise. I mean, you can hear the water, but that's a different topic.
Yeah, that's another story for another day. So there's the piano. and you've seen it, here it is, and you know, we will hopefully be doing concerts at some point, but Merry Christmas in the meantime. No, we'll do another video before then, but hopefully it'll be happening at some point before too long. This was not our plan, to be sitting here just enjoying the space. You know, the idea was that we're going to bring people on board and have a nice time, but it's just been us having a nice time so far. Or I have, anyway. You never have a nice time.
It's work. It's still work.
Yeah. Anyway, so thank you for joining us again. And next week, we shall see. We're still looking back, so at some point we'll catch up to where we are now. But next week, we're going to see the boat coming off its hard standing and making our way over to where we are now in Uxbridge or Harefield. So
from Watford.
Yeah, from Watford.
PNS Marine, where it was craned down. And then we journeyed down to here in Harefield. It's quite interesting how we hardly used the engine at all.
Oh, yeah,
we managed entirely on solar. So that was quite interesting. But that's for another day.
That's for next week. So see you then. Thank you.